A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 15th Feb, on the front page you have, following Supreme Court rap, telcos asked to pay AGR dues immediately. So we had seen the Supreme Court had adjudicated on this matter of adjusted gross revenues. So these are dues from the telecom companies to the government. So these are worth 1.47 lakh crore. So this judgment came in October 2019, but dues have still not been paid, and now Supreme Court is asking why contempt proceedings should not be initiated against them for failing to pay even a single penny to the government. So MDs and directors of the companies, telecom companies involved, that is Bharti Airtel and Vodafone Idea, have been asked to give response in this case. So this is the whole timeline. You can see it was in 2005 when government defined adjusted gross revenue calculation, which was challenged by the telecom firms. So adjusted gross revenue includes all revenues, while companies argue that it includes only revenues from core services. So that was the dispute. The dispute went before telecom dispute settlement and appellate tribunal, and the ruling there came, that the company's definition is right. So companies had won, but Supreme Court set aside tribunal's judgment saying government's definition is right and ordered telecom firms to pay 1.47 lakh crore to the government. That was in October 2019, and now in February 2020, Supreme Court threatens telecom firms with contempt proceedings and also slams officials for failing to enforce the ruling. So this you can see, furious bench issues show cause notice to Department of Telecom for letter staying the judgment. So not implementing court order is contempt of court. Then this is European Union calls for swift end to all curbs in Kashmir. So European Union has called for swift removal of communication and political restrictions in Kashmir and is in touch with the Indian authorities for a continuing dialogue on the situation in Kashmir. So EU is presently important because the EU-India summit is going to take place in Brussels. Then next is, Gujarat hostel girls checked for menstruation. So undergarments were inspected after complaints of temple and kitchen entry by some having periods were seen. So they were actually checked. Instructions for checking were reportedly given by hostel rector and the college principal. So at least 60 girls in a hostel in Gujarat's Kutch were allegedly asked to remove the undergarments to prove that they were not menstruating after complaints came. And this was also, an old practice which is condemnable, that while menstruating, the girl or woman should not enter temple or the kitchen. And this is Supreme Court lifts Delhi NCR construction ban. So the restrictions were partially eased by the court in December, and now it has completely lifted the ban on construction and demolition in Delhi NCR. So it's been over 3 months that it was stopped. Now the restrictions have been removed. So this was to curb pollution. And below you have UP government invokes National Security Act against Kafil Khan. So UP government has invoked this stringent provisions against Dr. Kafil Khan of Gorakhpur for his allegedly inflammatory comments against Citizenship Amendment Act at Aligarh Muslim University recently. So Kafil Khan was in news because he had been sent to jail, targeted by the Yogi Adityanath government in the Gorakhpur children deaths cases where oxygen supply was not provided. So he was made the scapegoat. He had no wrong was done by him. Even the ruling came in his favor, the report came in his favor, but government said that though the investigation report is in his favor, the final decision will be of the government whether to accept the report or not. So they did not accept the report, and now again when he is participating in an anti-citizenship amendment act protests, now National Security Act provisions have been slapped against him by Yogi Adityanath government. On page 9 you have Tamil Nadu's debt rises, revenue deficit set to double. So this is regarding Tamil Nadu's budget for 2020-21, which has been announced. This outstanding debt, net outstanding debt, is expected to rise significantly to over 4.56 lakh crores in 2020-21. He blames this as because of unexpected drop in the share of the state of in central taxes. And below you have new structure soon for Military Affairs Department. So Military Affairs Department is a new department which has been established under Ministry of Defense, and the Chief of Defense Staff, the newly formulated post, is the one which will head it, and which presently is occupied by retired General Bipin Rawat. So it is said, and the objective of this Military Affairs Department is to look into procurements. So procurements will be streamlined, a new structure will be there for this new department. And this is scientist radio tag Indian pangolin. So this is the animal pangolins. It is amongst the most trafficked animals in the world. And for the first time, scientists in India are going to radio tag Indian pangolin, which is an endangered animal and is rarely sighted in forests. So it has a thick scaly skin and it is hunted for its meat and used in because it is used in traditional Chinese medicines. And below you have Supreme Court issues order on death penalty pleas. So Supreme Court has now issued an administrative order saying that appeals against confirmation of death penalty by high courts will be mandatorily listed for hearing before a three-judge bench of the Supreme Court within 6 months of the admission as such. So here you can see that the order says, as soon as the appeal is filed, Supreme Court Registry would intimate the High Court concerned to send the original records of the case and other necessary documents within 60 days. And once the death penalty is admitted, appeal is admitted for the hearing, lawyers have exactly 30 days to file additional documents, if any. Then on the editorial page, you have the first editorial. Choice and candidacy. So this is regarding decriminalization of politics and how the Supreme Court has also given its rap on this. So it says decriminalization of politics cannot be achieved by judicial fiat alone. So judiciary, we saw in on front page yesterday, it spoke on how the candidates who are selected by the political parties and are given tickets to contest elections through them, then what is their background, what is the criminal background, what cases are against them, how many cases are there, complete detail has to be published by the political parties. So that the voters know exactly what the candidates, what are its qualifications, what are the crimes committed, what is the status of each of the case against him, and also why the parties chose him and thinks that he should contest elections. His winnability. Then this is second editorial, troubling data. So this talks about how growth in the country is not held back by high finance costs but by poor consumer demand. So this is highlighted in this editorial that the problem with the economy is presently facing is because there is lack of demand. So country may enter into recession is the concern, not that finance is costly, that government needs to make money easily available to the people. But money should be available in the hands of the people. Consumer demand has dropped. Then this is One Asia, Two Perspectives. So this is regarding Asian economic story, how it has moved from pessimism to optimism. So subject for two economists over 50 years apart. This talks about the viewpoints on Asian economy, on alternative viewpoints. And this is A Tale of Outbreaks, both in China. So this is regarding SARS outbreak and present new coronavirus outbreak. So unlike the earlier case of SARS crisis, this time China has handled the coronavirus epidemic better. But its secretive attitude still causes concern. Because even in Hubei, in Wuhan, where the epidemic broke out, the authorities did not bring the details to the fore till it felt that it could not be handled. So this secretive attitude is a concern when it is a health factor involved, and that too which can affect a huge majority of the population in the country as well as in the world. Then on the op-ed page on Saturdays, you have this ground zero coverage. So today this is regarding new coronavirus. So it is saying that Kerala is drawing from its experience in controlling the 2018 Nipah virus outbreak to prepare for a potential coronavirus, COVID-19 spread. So the government efforts are commendable, but there are still concerns involved. Because Kerala was the first state where people testing positive for new coronavirus were detected. Then on page 12 you have Supreme Court seeks Jammu and Kashmir reply to plea against Omar's custody. So it is said there has been no effort by authorities to verify truth behind information that Omar Abdullah was a threat to peace. This is what his sister Sara Abdullah Pilot says in the Supreme Court. So now Supreme Court is asking Jammu and Kashmir administration to reply on this. On page 13 you have Assam party petitions UN on validity of CAA, Citizenship Amendment Act. So this is a newly formed political party in Assam which has petitioned the United Nations for evaluating the compliance of Citizenship Amendment Act to international human rights instruments and its validity under Universal Declaration of Human Rights. So this is a step being taken. You can see it is Assam Songrami Mancha, which has approached the UN High Commission for Human Rights. Then on international page you have US refuses entry to Sri Lankan army chief. So this is because of his involvement in war crimes against Tamils. That Sri Lankan army chief has been refused entry to US. Entry in US. And here you have US says Huawei stole trade secrets, concealed North Korea links. So US Justice Department has added new criminal charges against telecom giant from China, Huawei, and several of its subsidiaries. It accuses the company of a brazen scheme to steal trade secrets from competitors like competitors in America, and also alleges that the company provided surveillance equipment to Iran that enabled monitoring of protesters during the 2009 anti-government demonstrations. So it also said that it was doing business, it sought to conceal business that it was doing in North Korea despite economic sanctions there. Then this is Israeli strikes kill 7 in Damascus. So Israeli strikes on Damascus airport killed 7 fighters. So this is the latest in a string of attacks targeting Iran's military presence in Syria. So Damascus is in Syria. There were three Syrian soldiers and the rest were members of Iran's Revolutionary Guard, which have been killed because of Israeli strike. And this is baby born on boat amongst 87 saved off Canary Island. So you should know about Canary Island. So you can see. So it is the, this route is used by migrants from sub-Saharan Africa. They travel 3 months on boat to reach Europe. And this is US Taliban reach Afghanistan truce agreement, says official. So, senior US official has said that US and the Taliban have reached a truce agreement that will take effect very soon and could lead to withdrawal of American troops from Afghanistan. So, two details have not come through, but the deal will take into effect. Agreement will take into effect very soon has been announced. On page 15, on business page, you have Bharti to make 10,000 crore part payment in AGR dues by Feb 20. So, Bharti Airtel has promised to clear remaining dues as well before March 17, the next date of the hearing. So, after Supreme Court rap, Bharti Airtel has agreed to make payments. And below you have Karnataka High Court stays Central Competition Commission of India order against Amazon and Flipkart. So, Center is probing FEMA violation charges against the telecom giant, e-commerce giants too. So now a relief to them has come because Karnataka High Court stayed the direction which Competition Commission of India gave, to investigate through its Director General into whether they had entered into anti-competitive agreements in violation of the Competitions Act or not. But Karnataka High Court says no need. It has stayed with it. And this is textile policy to be rolled out by mid-2020. So mega parks will be established which will help countries scale, spurring cost effectiveness. So this is planned under the textile policy for the country. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asr.com. Thank you.